Okay, so our today's topic is using this data frame, how we can use this rename function and how we can use this reindex function. Yesterday we also talked about this rename function. So this rename function is used to change the column indexes or the row indexes, to change the column names or to change row indexes. So it's very simple. It is basically used to rename the row indexes or the column indexes. By default, it works with, yesterday I already talked you about this, it works with row indexes. Okay, so yesterday I talked you this example. You can see this is a data frame that we have already created. Now you can see in this data frame, basically, let make this line comment. I'm making this line comment. What is actually the real data frame? So we have a data frame that having the three columns, roll number, name, and F name. And these are the value of this data frame. Let the program execute and so that we can see the actual output. Okay, so this is a data frame that we really have. Roll number, name, F name, and then these are the different row indexes. That I'm sharing this data frame with you. Okay, now what we want that its row indexes small a and small b should be renamed by capital A and capital B. Now how we can do this? We have to use this rename function, df.rename, and inside this function, small bracket and then close bracket, inside this function, we have to provide a dictionary which having the old name as a key and the new name as a value. So small a should be replaced by this capital A. Small b should be replaced by this capital B. So by default, rename function works with row indexes. So there is no need to mention the axis here. But we can mention it. Axis equals to index. Either we can write axis equals to index or either we can write axis equals to zero. Because the default value of axis is zero. So we can write axis equals to zero or axis equals to index. And there is one more thing which is important. Suppose we are not writing this in place equals to true, then what equals to true? Okay. You all are getting my voice? In place equals to true. So in place equals to true means the changes will reflect inside this df itself. So now suppose I'm printing df. So you can see the indexes small a and b are changes by this capital A and B. Is it clear to everyone? Say yes or no. Is it yes, clear sir. To everyone? Okay. So like this A and B, we can use the other name. Suppose I want this first. I want this second, whatever the name that we choose. So this small a index will be replaced by this first and b is replaced by this second. Let execute this. So you can see small a having now first and then small b having second. So like this we can
sorry, screen show nahi ho rahi.
Yes sir, screen show nahi ho rahi.
Okay.
Yes sir.
Now showing. Okay, so you can see here.
No, sir.
Now I am sharing the screen. You are able to see the screen?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. So df.rename.
लेकिन अब आपकी आवाज क्लियर नहीं आ रही.
Okay. df.rename a first and b second. So it will just change the index A by first and B by second. So you can see this output will appear. Now, what we want, so that means we have completed one thing. Which thing we have completed? We have completed changing the name of row indexes. Okay. Now what we want changing the name of columns. How we can change the name of columns? Now suppose instead I want to rename this roll number and name column. So for this df.rename, then the name of the column is suppose roll number. This is the old name. What is the first name? What is the new name actually? Suppose instead of roll number, I want this ROLL. Instead of this name, I want ST name. Okay. So roll number will be replaced as roll and name will be replaced as ST name. In place equals to true, because I want that the changes will reflect in this data frame itself. But what should I do? Access equals to index. What should I write here? Access equals to index. Any answer in this? Reina, what should I write?
Column.
X is equals to, we have to write the columns. I should write here X is equals to columns because I want to change the columns. Sanjana. Okay. Voice of Sanjana coming. So either I can write X is equals to columns or either I can write X is equals to 1. Both having the same thing. Okay, let's see the output of this. Now you can see this roll number is replaced by this roll and this name is replaced by this ST name. Clear? So like this, I can change the columns. I can rename the columns. Any doubt in this? Or I can also use X is equals to 1 also. So either I can write X is equals to column or either I can write X is equals to 1, both having the same output. So this is also having the same thing. I can write X is equals to 1 also. It is also getting the same output. Okay. Now there is one more method that I can use. Suppose I don't want to use this X is argument of this function, then simply you can write here columns equal to, then there is no need to mention this axis. Simply you can write like this, columns equals to, then roll number roll, name equals to this, in place equals to true. So this will also change the same thing, means roll and s. So this is also method by which we can change the columns. Having the same output. Similarly, to change the row indexes without mentioning the axis, you can write here. In the case of row, there is no need to mention here the columns and anything because by default it will access the indexes. But suppose you want to write, then you should write df.rename indexes equals to, then you have to mention the indexes. Suppose small a is by capital A, small b, right, capital B. You can also do like this. It will also change the row indexes. Change the name of row indexes. This is also a method. So this is our choice that how we want to change. We can use the access argument, or either there is no need to use this access argument. So suppose we don't want to use this access argument, then we can specify columns equals to, then index equals to, then the dictionary that we want to change. But remember, in a single rename function, both things cannot be changed. I mean, suppose we want to change the indexes as well as we want to change the column, then the different rename function should be used. Means in a single rename function, we cannot change both the row indexes and the column indexes. Means suppose I want this row indexes to be changed as well as I want the column indexes to be changed, then I have to use the different rename function. Suppose indexes equals to this, columns equals to, then again the same thing. Suppose the old name is roll number, the new name is capital roll, and then this is old name is name and the new name is st name. So we have to use a different rename function, and let's see the output. So it will change the both things, the row indexes as well as the column indexes, but we have to use a different rename function for this. So it will change the both the things. Means in a single rename function, we cannot do both the things, because compiler will not understand that whether you want to change the row and whether you want to change the columns. Okay, so this is about this rename function and the various combinations that can be used. Now we are going to discuss about this reindex function. So as the name suggests, reindexing means we want to change the existing indexing of the row and columns. So what is the use of this function? It is used, write down, it is used, write down the heading reindex function. And what is the use of this? It is used to change the row label. Indexes may be row label, means the user defined labeling that we have used for row and column, row labels and column label. Means basically what is the basic purpose of reindexing? To reorder the rows and columns, indexes. What do you mean by the reordering? Reordering means, suppose in this example, I am deleting this rename. Let's see the original data frame. So this is the original data frame. Reindexing is basically used when we want, suppose row indexes are A, B, C, D, E. Now suppose I want, that B index should be before, means B, C, D, A, E. Suppose I want this. Means the first index should be B, then A, then C, D, E. But remember, only these indexes will not change. All the row will be changed. Means suppose I want that in the first location, I have a B index, means B 12 Dinesh FF should be there at the first index value. Then in the second index value, I want this, then this should be at the second location, second index, then third. Means I want the reshuffling of these row indexes. Similarly, I can reshuffle these columns also. Suppose at the first, I want F name column with their values. Then second, I want name, then third, I want roll number. This is the motive for which we can use this reindex function. So it is very simple. Reindexing means reshuffling of the existing row indexes or column indexes. How we can use df dot reindex? Then suppose I want to change the indexes. Indexes equals to, then you have to mention the actual sequence that you want. Suppose B, comma C, then I want D, then I want A, then I want E. So this is the sequence that I want. There is one double quote is missing. Okay, df dot reindex, index equals to this, means this is actually the new this is not a new index, basically reshuffling the existing index. So inside this reindex, remember always that we have to provide the existing index of the data frame, not any the new index. Let's see the output. Now you can see the output is same. Nothing is changed. The indexes are not shuffled. Why? indexes are not shuffled. Why it is? Any answer?
Curly brackets.
No, curly bracket is not needed. Curly bracket are needed in the rename function where we have to mention the old index with the new name. Actually, reindex function is in place, because reindex is use working same like rename. So it will return a new data frame. It will not make the changes in DF itself. So here also we have to use this in place equals to true. Why? Because we want that these changes should be made inside the DF itself. So let's see the output. Reindex got unaccepted keyword argument.
Sir, in place kyun use karte hain?
Basically, this in place is used when we want that changes made by this reindex function should be happened with this existing data frame DF. अगर ये हम use नहीं करते हैं तो वो DF में changes नहीं होते हैं. लेकिन ये rename के साथ तो सही काम कर रहा था, but with the use of this reindex, it is giving me an error. So suppose we want that these changes should be inside this DF, then I can write like DF equals to DF dot reindex. Means whatever the changes made by this reindex will be restored in DF itself. So I will find the solution why in place is not working, but using this function DF equals to DF dot reindex, it is working. You can see the first index is D, then C, then D, then A, then E, as we want here. And the entire row will be shifted towards that index. Okay, so this is the way by which we can re-index the existing row indexes. Similarly, suppose we want to re-index the columns also. So in the same function, we can use columns equals to, then you have to provide the sequence of the column. Suppose first I want name, then in second I want F name, then third I want roll number. So it will change the entire data frame. Means the row indexes are this and column indexes are this. Let's see the output. Okay, so you can see first name is there, then F name, then roll number, then this row indexes B, C, D. And you can see the values are also changing. Means name is the first column. So now Dinesh is here, then FF, then 12 with their indexes. So in a single re-index function, we can re-index both the columns with the rows. Suppose we want to change only the column, then you just have to mention the columns equals to this. Suppose we want only to change the indexes, then you can use index equals to this. And suppose you want to both, then you can use index equals to this comma columns equals to this. What it will do, it will just shift the columns only.
Sir?
Yes.
Sir, agar isko DF mein hi nahi karne ki jagah ek naye kuch naye variable mein save karte, to fir DF mein change hota hai nahi hota?
नहीं, तो नहीं होता. जैसे मैं मान लो इसको df1 में ले रहा हूँ, दैट इज गुड क्वेश्चन. सपोज df1 इक्वल्स टू df डॉट रीइंडेक्स दिस, देन आई एम प्रिंटिंग df1. सो df1 होल्ड दैट थिंग, न्यू थिंग. बट सपोज आई एम प्रिंटिंग द df, df विल बी सेम लाइक एज बिफोर. सो यू कैन सी फर्स्ट आई हैव प्रिंटेड df1 व्हिच हैविंग द नेम फर्स्ट, देन f नेम, देन रोल नंबर. But second is your DF, original DF, which is not changing roll number, name, and then F name.
Okay.
So suppose we want to changes in DF itself, then we have to write DF equals to DF dot index. The same thing we can write in rename also, DF equals to DF dot rename. Clear? I can make this also in your group. So like this, we can use this reindex function. Suppose we have a data frame df here. Here we have a data frame df. Now suppose I want a new data frame df1 or df2 or another data frame, and we want that the new data frame should have a same index like this df2 and something like this. Then I can do this like df1 dot, means I can copy the index of one data frame in the second data frame. Let's see how.